What's up, everybody? This is the Awesome Nerd Show, back again playing Ark Survival Evolved. So I'm trying to think of what our plans for today could be. I did do some things off camera. I think I did some gathering. It's been a while since I played. I did some exploring and got some stuff. So I got this dodo named Princess. Now I got it because it was a 120, I think, which of course was the old highest level you could get. So when I saw it, I got excited. Then I forgot that you could get 150s though. But I got it. I was trying to think of a name for it, and it was all purple, so I thought of Prince, but it's a female, so I switched it to Princess and everything. And so we have some eggs on it, pump some health into it. So this is just our little dodo we have, and of course we can pick it up and go into Cayman and see how funny it looks holding the dodo. We can run around holding our dodo. But of course in the first person view it kind of looks all weird and everything. There it looks normal, but when you're in first person it's like I'm not even holding on to it. It's a floating dodo. And then we'll just, whoops. There, and just throw it down. Good enough. And so we have both of our trikes. So I did some leveling up a little. I just did some more killing of dinos and gathering. And then I also got over here Petey, which is the Pteranodon. I think it was a 115. Looks like he's got a level. Go ahead and pump some weight so it can carry us some. So now we can fly wherever we need to. So I think today we're going to fly around the island to see if we can possibly find a new place to live, because I don't want to get a whole lot of dinos and everything going before we have a new place, because then that's a lot more we have to move and everything. Or dinos, at least, to worry about moving, because I mean we have all these chests of stuff, which is going to take a while. We have the boat and everything down there. Which I used, I built some stuff onto it. Oh, better check to make sure there's nothing dangerous out here. And I don't see anything close by. So we should be relatively good on that. But I built the raft as I had done in one of the previous episodes. And then I put wooden foundations on it to make it a larger area. Then I put a bed and some boxes, because when I went exploring, so I put some extra material in case I died. And then I did have some like extra stuff I gathered, but I probably emptied that into there. And so, I want to see if I can find a new place to live. Let me run up to the house here. So pull out the map. So as you can see, there's a spot marking me, so there's like a little push pin in the thing. Now I would prefer to stay somewhere on the mainland, so probably in what are called the jungle area, so between the longitudes of, I would say, probably the 40 to 70, which is about where I am, and latitudes 40 to 90, so that like big chunk of land, pretty much where I'm at. But the three islands, they like to stay somewhere around there. But my requirements are, it needs to be relatively flat and close to water, so I can do planning and stuff like that and not have to worry about water. Even though I did think about it though, it does rain a lot on the center map here, and so I could just do the like water reservoirs and or something. So I may think about doing that if I find a nice place, but don't want to move or I can't find a good spot that meets my requirements or anything. So I've got a few things to do real quick, and so first off I'm going to get something to drink, and then I'll grab some more food to eat. I got a spyglass made, which I don't think I had the last episode, But I want to try and make some more of some arrows and stuff just to take with me. And then I'll need some other stuff. Looks like Princess laid another egg. But I want some more arrows and stuff because I got made some crossbows. So I was able to go and get metal. So I'll just go ahead and place all these down here. And then I'll probably drop this bow and put that one into storage so I have some metal there. And then, of course, I have some extra metal in there. Go ahead and place what I have here. Do I have any in there? Just one piece. Go ahead and store that on there. See if we can make any of the other weapons. So melee. So it looks like I need hide. See if we have any hide. We do have hide. Good. I don't think I need that much though, but we'll go ahead and put this in there. Make two of everything. Then we need to get more wood. So let's see. Two pikes and two sickles. So now we have a sickle, so getting fiber and everything will no longer be an issue. We'll put the pike on six, maybe. We'll put it there, maybe. Oh, got some lag going on. Okay, and I guess we're back, guys. So my game crashed, it looks like. So I don't know how much stuff got recorded and everything, so hopefully everything's still up and going. And so when I came back in, all my stuff that I was doing was no longer there. So I need to recraft everything that I was crafting. So that's the first time the game's ever crashed on me, so it kind of freaked me out and everything, not knowing what was going on. But I do believe it has happened, but it's not rare or anything. Let's go ahead and make. I think the gamma's too high up. May have to get out of the. There we go. There, hopefully it's easier to see now. Go ahead and make that. Then we need the wood. Least I wasn't doing anything major and anything that would have got me killed. Then we'll make two pikes and two sickles again. See what else there is. So we need a lot more metal to make a gun. And then of course the ammo and the crossbow, which we have. There we go. Pike and a sickle. Go ahead and leave those two in there. Let's put this hatchet and the pick. The sickle there. And I guess the pike on six. Then we'll drop that and drop all those. We have a pike now, so we don't need the spear. Put the trunks there. I'll have to put that bow up maybe. Let's see if we do already have two, so I'll just go ahead and drop that one. And we do have some trank arrows. And some stone arrows. So I guess we don't really need to make any more because we should be good on that. So as I was saying before, oh, princess just lays eggs galore. I'll have to, of course I'm not anywhere. Oh, I guess those were eggs from earlier. Pump levels again. See if anything else needs levels pumped before we fly away. Go the way as I said. Probably just do a little wait. We'll see how well it PD holds me. So it is kind of way down. But not to the max yet, so we should be relatively good. I'm going to land back down and make some parachutes, and I forgot to get water because I have a problem with falling off my dinos when I'm playing on the computer here because of the confusion of all the buttons and everything. So I may want to have some parachutes just in case. So we'll go in here. And I need to find the parachute. There it is. And I believe they're pretty easy to make. Thatch, fiber, and hide, yeah. So grab some fiber. Some thatch. And then of course some shell grab the hide out of here. Make two of them. Okay, now I gotta figure out where I should put them. I'm gonna put all this stuff in there. I guess we'll put it on the sickle spot. Since I shouldn't be needing the sickle. Then I'll run out and grab water, and I probably should grab some meat as well. So grab a drink. Come in, shut the doors. Now, where did I put? I think it's still on Mikey. Yeah, there's me. There we go. That should be everything, hopefully. So let's see where we're at here. Okay, so we need to fly probably in the direction we are facing. So it shows there's water almost right behind us over here, it looks like. So I'll fly over there, and I'm just going to try and look at all these spots that have water around them, or the water that's on the map, and that's not what I wanted, and see how dangerous they look and everything, because I know on the center map here there are, or at least I've heard that there are a lot of gigas. Well, that's not, ooh, there's a Giganto. There are gigas in multiple places. So whoa, what's in here? A bunch of dealers. This place doesn't look too bad. There's the water. I mean, there's not a lot of room you can grow in. Ooh, a beaver dam. I've never got a beaver dam before. But there are a lot of beavers too, and they'd probably kill me. So that is the first. Ooh, a Quetzal. I need a Quetzal. Of course, right now I'm not ready to get one. There's some raptors. Let's fly up here and see what level this Quetzal is. Where's your level? Oh, there's another one. There's Quetzals galore down here. So now we're up high here, so we can kind of see some stuff. Now, as I mentioned, I really do want to get a Quetzal, but there's, so I've tried it on the other map and everything to get a Quetzal by myself, since that's obviously how I'm playing, but I was not able to do it at all. I tried everything, you know, all the tricks and everything, and I did it, but they never worked out. And so I think if I do try to do a Quetzal, I may just have to cheat and tame it with commands or something, because like I said, I could not do it by myself, and I don't have anyone on here that could help me. So here's some of those ruins, which are really cool. I've seen multiple videos of. So let's look around at these things. Oh, this is so cool. It'd be cool to build in these. There is some water here. But it'd be cool if the ruins were right on the water, because I am obviously going to have to run water pipes and everything, so that's why I want it close to the water. There's Bronos everywhere. Ah, this place is so amazing. Some more raptors and Bronos. And from what I've been told, is that the ruins, or at least the people that I talked to that have played, the ruins have had gigas around them. So that's why I'm kind of worried being around all these ruins and everything. But I guess we won't know until we see one or anything, and it could varies game to game stuff. So that one wouldn't be too bad. Being in those ruins. Let's fly up here. Of course, this would be the entrance steps. So you have this whole thing. And so up here, if you like blocked up the steps and everything, you wouldn't have to worry about anything coming and like hurting you or killing you or anything. This is really awesome, because you just block off all the main stairways, because then the only thing that's dangerous would be flyers, and there's not really any dangerous flyers around here, because the only thing that could be are Argies. But we would have to watch out for Gigas, just in case, because they could obviously reach up higher. So if we had dinos in there and everything, they could attack stuff. Okay. So let's keep flying here. So there's more ruins over here. We'll see what these ones look like. So this one has a stream. Oh, out of stamina. Forgot about needing stamina. No, don't fall in the water. Ah. Thankfully that did not kick me off. Hopefully there's nothing dangerous around here. There's a Gallimimus. Pee pooped. Some more stairs there. Some Bronos. I'm surprised there's this many ruins around here. I didn't think there would be that many. There's a Carno. That's a cool place. Got some beaver dams. Oh, and a lot of beavers. So there's what, two dams in there? Because there's one right there. Wow. Good place to get cementing paste. So, of course, we have our stuff loaded with dinos. Ooh, there's some big trees going on here. Oh, there's Nargi. Wow, I didn't think there were any RGs on the main islands. So there's a T-Rex. This place is getting kind of dangerous. I don't know, I really like that ruin that's right over there. So then, of course, we're getting closer to the center part. Of course, obviously, that this map is named after. So we'll see if we can fly over here real quick and get that loaded in. Oh, there's a stego on the ledge. Don't jump, your life's worth more than that. So afraid of just flying into a giga. But yeah, my goal is to try and live inland because usually the inlands are harder to live on than like on the oceans, because then the ocean with the oceans and everything, you only have one side to worry about. You know, because the front's water, so you don't have to worry about that. Level 40. And then you just have the back of yourself to block off, where inland you have all directions and everything. And so here's the island, as you can see. And I think I'll fly over to that and just kind of fly around in there, show you. But I think, as of right now, that ruins that I was just flying around is probably gonna be where I'm gonna move to. I'll kind of fly around in it a little more and get a layout of stuff, but I think that would provide plenty of room. And it's got the flat base, so if I need to put down a lot of parasaurs over here. But if I would need, whoa. There's a huge fight going on. Stuff's just flying everywhere. Ooh, 145 parasaur. I've never had a parasaur. Oh yeah, there's, well maybe, the new leeches. Oh shoot, I better. Maybe there's a Sarco. Make sure I get some stam before I go killing myself. I don't know where a good place to land would be. Maybe here. Hopefully nothing can reach up here. But there's the new leeches in the water, so I don't want to get anywhere near the swamp and worry about leeches attaching onto me. But yeah, I think I'll build in that ruins. Unless I find some other place and stuff, but we'll get some stamina here and fly up to the main thing, and I'll be right back. Okay, and we're back, and I am on the center island of the center. And as you can see, this is the inside of the rock. And of course, there's the large oasis water. Of course, a lot of fights going on. Now, I have before seen gigas in this, so hopefully there's no gigas around here. I'll try and stay flying high so they don't attack. But we'll fly up here to the top. It was real foggy when I was flying up, so I don't know if it was just all the water around. Oh, there goes something flying. Or if there was actually fog or what's going on, but hopefully there's not. Yeah, there's kind of fog. I don't know if it's my settings or what. Take a land down here. Actually, I may move over to that rock, since it looks like it's a little bit higher up, or this one. So this place is just obviously amazing. Such a beautiful island. they did an amazing job on this. So as you can see, I'll pull up the map. So I am on the center island, as you can see the pin. Then off into this direction is around the 40, between 40 latitude and longitude of the 10 and 20. There's an iceberg type place there. Then there's one over there to the south, towards the bottom of the map on the left. And so there's the back of the land, which just like cuts off. And then we look forward. So there's the volcano island, the like death island, which is at latitude 30, longitude 80, kind of mark that island. Then the next island right here, just to the right of the map point, that's the corner's pointing at. That's where I went to get some of the materials, like the metal, and I got crystal for spyglass, everything. Stuff there's what looks like a giant head, which I may fly over there real quick. But yeah, this place is just amazing. I'm here on, as I said, on the center. It's kind of funny seeing this waterfall come out of the top of the cliff up here. Let's see if I can, and it falls down into the center oasis thing. So that is really cool. This place is just awesome. Let's see if we can fly. So here is the entire island map, as you can see. Of course, then there's a huge waterfall. So the center thing here is just completely floating. It's surrounded by water on all sides with waterfalls, and then there's swamp on the edge and everything. But this is just so awesome, and of course it's hard to find where I want to live, but I think that place, which I believe it's right here, where the top of PD's head is pointing right along here, is where I think we'll go, which seems to be a good place because kind of towards the very center of the map, so it's not far from the center thing here, or any of the outer islands and stuff. Looks like there would be probably a nice waterway to get there on rafts if I need to get over to any of the islands and stuff. So I think that's probably off camera. I'll go searching around more, make a final decision of where I want to move, and then start building. So that should probably be the next episode, is starting the build to see if I can possibly block off entrances and everything to keep the dinos out. So I'll fly back over here and get one last look of it real quick. Excuse me. And that should probably be the end of this episode. Oh, there's a Spino. Definitely have to worry about that. So there's this whole area down here that we can use. Of course, just probably put a behemoth gate up right here. Should block that off. And I don't know about that whole pillar situation there. Maybe I'll put like the pillars we can build up in there. Then of course there's this side, which again we can just put up some stuff to keep dinos from coming in. And so there's this whole area. There's a little cave there that just goes through. There's these steps that come up here to an upper area, which again we can keep stuff stored. Then here's another inside, which would be nice to have a lot of the dinos and everything. Maybe it's just my wings. They look like there was a dino in there. And then up here where we can have all sorts of the like building materials and everything. And this could be the sort of like safety area type thing. Then put like a dino gate here somewhere to block that off. So I think this is going to be it. Then I can just run pipes down to the water or find a place along somewhere to put like the start of the kibble farm and everything. But I think this is going to be it. But I'll at least try it and see how it goes. We'll have to see if we can build in any of this stuff. I'm not exactly sure if they have any rules or limits on the stuff here, but I guess we'll find out and everything. So I think that'll be it for this episode and kind of here in our new home and everything. So thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to hit the like button if you enjoyed it. It's just kind of like a slow episode, just flying around, finding a new place. Of course, I had the game crash and everything, so that was new and interesting. But yeah, so hit that thumbs up button. Subscribe for more ARK videos, which it, so far it's been about two every week. Would like to do more than that, but with the way time has worked out and everything, and be having such a busy schedule as I do, I do whenever I can. Turn up the gamma here real quick. There we go. Saw the fireflies flying around. But yeah, I'm hoping to get more, but there's so far been two every week. But yeah, so do that. Leave any comments you have for me of anything I missed, or any good locations if you want to supply the latitudes and longitudes and everything. If you have anything that matches what I've described or anything. But thank you for watching, and we'll see you next episode.